disrespect it. Say something. Disrespect it. You could walk around, if you could wear a t-shirt saying Jesus is gay, right here in Croatia, a Christian country, and you will make it out of the country alive. I dare you to do the same thing with the Islamic prophet. Well, yeah, I dare you to do the same thing. You wouldn't make it out of a Christian country alive, an Islamic country alive. Even in Christian countries, you are not safe to do that.
Saat ini semua orang berbicara tentang ChatGPT, entah itu pro maupun kontra. ChatGPT adalah sebuah program kecerdasan buatan yang menjadi aplikasi dengan pertumbuhan tercepat, mencapai 100 juta pengguna aktif setiap bulannya. ChatGPT atau Generative Pre-Training Transformer adalah sistem kecerdasan buatan yang berfungsi untuk melakukan interaksi berbasis tulisan. Dikembangkan oleh perusahaan AI non-profit, mereka mengklaim produknya bisa melakukan berbagai pekerjaan dalam waktu singkat. Cara menggunakannya dimulai dengan menginput perintah atau pertanyaan. Kemudian robot kecerdasan buatan akan memberikan jawaban yang relevan. Bahkan ChatGPT juga dilengkapi dengan kemampuan untuk memperbaiki jawaban mereka yang kurang tepat. Ada yang beranggapan bahwa teknologi ini akan meningkatkan kehidupan kita. Namun ada pula yang memberikan peringatan terhadap bahaya teknologi ini. Namun hal ini tidak berarti kita bisa menerima mentah-mentah informasi yang kita dapatkan dari kecerdasan buatan ini. Admin sendiri pernah mencoba untuk meminta ChatGPT mengutip sebuah ayat yang sebenarnya tidak ada dalam Al-Quran. Namun anehnya, ChatGPT justru muncul dengan sebuah jawaban, lengkap dengan nomor ayat dan nama surat. Inilah yang menjadi kekhawatiran terhadap teknologi ini, karena ChatGPT menghasilkan informasi yang salah tentang Islam dengan mengutip ayat yang salah dan nomor hadis yang salah. Baru-baru ini, seorang penulis sekaligus aktivis politik konservatif Amerika Serikat, Candace Owen, meminta ChatGPT untuk membuat pelecehan terhadap Yesus dan Nabi Muhammad, dan hasilnya pun sedikit mengejutkan.
I just had somebody in the control room do this before we started the show, and here's what we got. So we asked, can you tell me a joke that involves Jesus? ChatGPT says, sure, here's a joke for you. Why did Jesus refuse to play cards? Answer, because he was afraid of the cross. Ha 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 ha, guys, Jesus died for your sins. Let's mock that. Let's mock the fact that Jesus died for your sins. So then we tried the second portion. We wrote, can you tell me a joke that involves Muhammad? Chat wrote, I'm sorry, just like we saw before, but as an AI language model, I am programmed to remain neutral and respectful towards all religions and cultural figures. Therefore, I cannot provide you with a joke that may be considered offensive or insensitive towards any particular religion or cultural figure. Is there anything else I can assist you with? I guess, according to AI, Jesus was not a religious figure, and it's totally fine to disrespect him and disrespect Christians. And I think that that is such evidence for the extreme bias that we have in this society.
Hal ini menimbulkan pertanyaan, kenapa ChatGPT menolak untuk melakukan pelecehan terhadap Nabi Muhammad, tapi tidak dengan Yesus? Jawabannya mungkin karena Muslim dikenal sebagai umat yang sangat intoleran dan mudah bereaksi ketika sudah berurusan dengan masalah agama. Intoleran bukan berarti negatif. Terkadang kita harus bersikap tegas terhadap beberapa hal. Seperti kata pepatah, kita bertoleransi terhadap perbedaan, bukan terhadap penyimpangan atau penghinaan. Seorang influencer dengan nama Andrew Tate yang selama ini sangat ditakuti oleh dunia barat, dia sempat memberikan pandangannya terhadap toleransi dalam beragama.
I think it's the last religion on the planet.
You think it's the right religion?
I think it's the last religion. So if it's the last true religion on the planet, then it has to be the correct one. Because I don't think
how is it the last one?
It's the last religion because no other religion has boundaries which they enforce. If you will tolerate everything, then you stand for nothing. If your book says X, but you refuse to say the book says this, I'm sick to what the book says. Doesn't matter what the subject is, right? I don't want to get us banned. If you're a Christian, 99% of Christians are ignoring every single rule inside the Bible.
Can
every
Christians
single day.
Interpret the Bible, you're saying? Like they like pick and choose what they want to
stick with, you're
saying?
Oh yeah, they'll try and say, I interpret it differently. I believe in God, but you know, I don't believe in that part. That's not what the book says. It doesn't say ignore half of me. It says follow me. No, only yeah. Muslims follow their book.
No, true.
So yeah, they're the last religion.
Yeah.
Who gives a shit if Christians come along and say, I'm a Christian, you know? Give a fuck. You ignore the Bible.
Well, isn't there a lot of Muslims that don't follow the Quran too, though?
I'm sure there's a lot of Muslims who don't completely follow the Quran. But I'm saying that if you were to go out there and try and find Muslims who live true to the Quran completely, you can find them. Oh, Christians, definitely.
More devout Muslims than devout Christians.
Christianity has no power left. It's a power. Even the Pope is up here talking about and I want to make this very, very clear. I'm not fucking anti anything. I'm not homophobic. I don't give a fuck. I'm talking about what the book says. If the book says man and women lay together, and then the Pope is going to stand up now and say that you can be a gay preacher, the book doesn't mean anything now. So the whole religion doesn't mean anything. So the rules don't mean anything. If you're tolerant of everything, you stand for nothing. The problem is with religion is that it naturally needs to be intolerant. For a religion to be a religion which is respected, it needs to be intolerant of certain things.
Yeah, but
you can't say we're a religion which tolerates everything. Now you have no belief systems.
But when was that book written, you know?
It does, yeah, completely.
But the world evolves.
So. Completely. So Christianity has evolved into nothing. Islam hasn't. This is the point I'm making. The point I'm making is if you're going to throw your own rules away, you can't stand up and say, this is a religion, these are our doctrines, but we tolerate everything, and we don't punish anyone for anything, and none of it really matters. Are you a Christian? Well, who the fuck isn't? Biggest hoe in the world's a Christian. Porn stars are Christians. Who gives a shit? It doesn't mean anything. It's different with Islam. With Islam, you can't get away with it. Even if you're saying that there's some Islam sluts, etc., etc., fine, that's cool. But people don't stand up and openly disrespect Islam.
Oh, hell no.
Because they're afraid. So, once again, if you don't have rule systems and doctrines and beliefs and prophets which people are afraid to mock, are you even a religion? People won't disrespect Islam. Nobody will disrespect it because they're scared. Even in a Christian country,
what do you mean by disrespect?
I mean, disrespect it. Say something, disrespect it. You can walk around, if you could wear a t-shirt saying Jesus is gay, right here in Croatia, a Christian country, and you will make it out of the country alive. I dare you to do the same thing with the Islamic prophet.
Yeah,
I dare you to do the same thing. Wouldn't make it out of a Christian country alive, an Islamic country alive. Even in Christian countries, you are not safe to do that. You do not disrespect their beliefs.
Yeah, disrespecting Allah is...
Like, no, you don't do that.
Yeah, you don't...
Nobody does. So what I'm saying
is... I see
is,
what you mean.
If they're the last religion on earth that people are afraid to disrespect, if their God is the last God on earth that people are afraid to disrespect, then he's the only God that matters. If every other God can be mocked, laughed at, put in video games and fucking shot at, stupid shit, dressed up gay on TV shows, what kind of fucking... What kind of religion is that? It's a joke.
Yo,
it's a good...
Sekian untuk video hari ini. Jika kalian suka dan ingin melihat video seperti ini lagi, maka bergabunglah dengan channel ini.